And of course, then I hear Tsarian talking, and he's, of course, talking about Akhenaten, but doing very good to not at all connect him with Obama, because then that would, of course, lead to me. So I was having a great day as I watched Tsarian and Alex Jones battle with the fact that they had to deal with my information that I'm bringing forth to you. Then I check out Jack Blood, another one of my favorites over at Deadline Live, and he brings on none other than David Icke and starts grilling him on the goddess Columbia. Now, Jack Blood and I have had many opportunities to hang out in his backyard and drink a few beers and talk about the goddess, so I had great fun listening to David Icke trying to grapple with my data once again. There is more to this story on planet Earth, and they are leaking it to us through predictive programming shows such as ABC Disney's V, or Defying Gravity, Firefly, and all the others. So to discuss the ideas of V and the predictive programming and how they've released this out, I mean, this is pre-David Icke. This is back in the early 80s. I have Alex Ansari joining me here tonight because he just watched that whole series again. And bravo to you, Alex.
Hey, thanks, Freeman. Yeah, it was interesting to watch it last night. There's a couple episodes. You can watch them for free on the internet. But, yeah, Freeman, it's highly prophetic. Highly prophetic film for its time.
Now, did you notice that the symbols on the front of their spacecraft were basically a swastika, just two arms missing?
It did look just like a swastika.
And then, of course, what they were bringing was nothing more than Nazi programming. I mean, when we take it to the new version, where they're saying, well, we're bringing you world health, we're bringing you ways to bring life easier, and of course, the idea that they were saying, we're an advanced race, and oh my God, here are more humans. We had no idea you existed. Now, this is all the new V. Have you watched it?
The new V, I haven't seen it yet. I actually don't have a TV, so I'm not catching the latest on ABC.
Yeah,
I haven't seen it on the web yet. Someone can email me if they got it, but no.
Okay, well, I had to run over to a friend's house to watch it as well, so don't worry. So in comparing the two, actually, it seemed like the new V encompassed the entire first episode or series in one episode. We were immediately introduced into this reptilian line, and of course, they had a character that was very much like me, heading up this this back force that were going to try and take the reptilians out, who were trying to tell the people, hey, they've been here all along. This is not something that is new to planet Earth.
Yeah, there was a lot of interesting stuff in that film. Humans being used to control other humans. The fact they were disguising themselves. Let's see what stood out. Obama youth. We talk a lot about in our today's world about the youth. You know, working for the government, civilian defense forces. And we kind of see a similar buildup in that film as well, where they're working with the reptilians. They don't know the reptilians. They look like us. But they're working with them as a youth Stasi force, turning in scientists. In the film V, the original 80s miniseries, scientists, anthropologists, microbiologists are threats. And so they stage a series of headlines that they use in the film. They have propaganda mouthpieces where they're saying scientists are the enemies, like terrorism today or domestic terrorism. So in the film, scientists are the enemy and a police state set up. And Freeman, it gets into a lot of interesting areas.
They definitely let us have it. They put it out there. They weren't worried about it because no one was ready for this type of reality yet. And just kind of a test run to see where we went with it, right? I mean, who was that? Oh, I was trying to remember the host, Beastmaster, who starred in the original series. I can't think of his name, Mark something.
A lot of interesting stuff back in the 80s. Definitely got to say. The way that he was describing the appearance of the reptilians is similar, according to David Icke and his research, to what people have shown him. Pictures, even Kruto Mutra, the shaman in South Africa. There's interviews of that available on the internet they can watch for free to see what this African shaman had to say about the reptilian race that they believed lived underground. But what he's drawing in this film, V, the original miniseries from the 80s, is just like what's seen in David Icke's books. So that's really interesting. I suppose the same thing could be said about Enemy Mine, that film as well that came out in the 1980s.
very much. That was a very good one. Louis Gossett Jr. playing an alien in that one, alongside of, I can't remember his name, but yeah, that was a good one. I enjoyed Enemy Mine. Yeah, there have been, you know, I was raised on like Space 1999 and many of these other sci-fi stories that were out when we were children. And it did have a lot to do with, you know, my reality and how I look at things. And maybe that's why I'm open to looking at the extraterrestrial hypothesis. Well, that, and, you know, it goes right back to my own life and my own world. So,
yeah. One more thing I'll point out about the film, too, since we're on the topic, is the mind control that was being used on the humans that stepped aboard the ship. And the United Nations Secretary General, when he went up to the ship, after that, all of a sudden he was writing with his left hand, where prior to that he was writing with his right hand. And there were some people that were noting in the film, it was almost genius how this was put together, the screenplay. There's something that happened to this guy when he encountered these beings, where it's not him anymore. There's a different personality in that body. Right. And it makes you think. Absolutely. And it raises a lot of serious questions. And I think we should raise some serious questions as to why our world leaders really want a new world order. The CFR, the Bilderberg Group, I think, you know, we're just scratching the surface. There's more that needs to be investigated here.
Oh, yeah, this story goes deep, and I do believe it goes extraterrestrial. And really, that's what I want to show in my new works that are coming out, because I found so many of the Atlanteans versus the reptiles, or the fish people versus reptilians, all over London and Liverpool, in the cathedrals, in the monuments, the memorials. Constantly, across the whole U.S. and England, we'll find this story of the reptilians versus the fish people. And when we start to take this story and we can apply it to ancient architecture and even modern architecture and show this consistent tale of these alien beings intermingling with planet Earth and actually bringing about stages of evolution in planet Earth, and contacting us through high profile or high ritual done in these dark offices. Now, it reminds me of, of course, They Live, which reminds me of the Chemtrails video. But
I got to say, that was great. I pass that on, Freeman, to a lot of people. I try to show it to people all the time to make them laugh, especially people that are into this stuff, because there's some humor in that. I mean, for those that haven't seen it, yeah, you definitely got to check it out. Freeman playing, you know, the character from They Live, actually manufacturing the sunglasses. And, it was interesting. It's kind of like that as people wake up. You kind of see these people kind of waking up from a trance as they start to see the messages all over in this downtown environment. It was really good for him. Definitely, definitely. Congratulations on that.
Well, thank you. Thank you. And thanks for joining us, Alex. I'll have to let you go.
All right. See you guys in just a little bit after Freeman Show.
Video Freeman episode called I Think I'm Insane, and that is I Think Therefore I'm Insane. And I'll leave you with this, you guys. Thanks for tuning in. I'll see you all next week, and we'll do this all again. We'll get deeper and deeper, I promise. I felt a little bit like I didn't hit all the points I meant to, but it's hard in these few moments that I have with you. So keep checking the blog for updates. I'm updating it all the time. And keep checking FreemanTV.com for more videos and information. And you guys, thank you.
You all know this revolution coming, and it's coming fast. It's just right around the corner now.
I look around and look for really meaningful signs that we're about to really change. I don't see it right now.
And we're going to look now what some of the most popular stories of the day on CNN.com are, and definitely the Anna Nicole Smith story, but there are other stories as well. Richard Louie is live in the Pipeline Control Room, and he joins us with a look. Richard, what do you have on these random attacks? It's such a sad trend.
Yeah, teen sports killings is what it is. Let's be honest. And if you have kids in the room, please ask them to leave for a second, because I'm going to just be real honest with you. This is, for a lot of sick people, this is masturbation to hot women who are dead.
Nature's been going crazy. All kinds of unusual catastrophes, like a nature hike through the Book of Revelation.
Effectively, what we call propaganda. and I'm influencing your children.
Like a fool, Miles, and accept it.
No. Never.
He's in here! He's in here! Get him!
And, that's when it... The nightmare became a reality.
Perhaps the most shocking homeless beating happened January 12th of last year in Fort Lauderdale, Florida, when a surveillance camera captured two teenagers beating a homeless man with a bat. Police say three teenagers went on a rampage, beating three homeless men.
Okay, I'm going to be real honest with you. I'm a typical guy. I think hot women are just great. I really do. It's like I think that God has put some sort of steel in their butts and magnets in my eyes because... No matter how hard I try, it's like, oh, look there. With that being said, I at least try not to look at these things. And now we're doing as a society, we're not only showing hot women all the time, we're mixing it with death.
Tana did talk about death. She talked about death really from the time that I met her.
When you go out very often till 4 o'clock in the morning and you meet people, you do something, things you don't even know the next day what you did.
Especially near the end of her life, where she seemed to be under the influence of drugs, And in this one, she just seemed pure angry.
Britney Spears came in and sat in my chair and said, I want to shave my hair off. And I said, well, I'm not shaving your hair off.
A moment's sleep, and the girl I loved was an inhuman enemy bent on my destruction. That moment's sleep was death to Becky Soul, just as it had been for Jack and Teddy and Dan Kaufman and all the rest. Their bodies were now hosts, harboring an alien form of life, a cosmic form, which to survive must take over every human man. So I ran as little Jimmy Grimaldi had run the other day. My only hope was to get away from Santa Mira, to get to the highway, to warn the others of what was happening.
What was discovered in Dahmer's apartment was horrifying. Body parts in a barrel, a human head in a refrigerator. When he confessed, the gruesome details were almost impossible to comprehend.
What was it, Jeff, that took you over the edge?
A new scientific study shows that for the first time they're finding polar bears that have actually drowned.
But it could.
Yeah, it should have killed 500 people, then I would have felt better. Then when I felt like I really offered society something, believe me, if I started murdering people, there'd be none of it left.
So far off in the environmental extreme, we'll be up to our neck in owls and out of work for every American.
We didn't do nothing. We're just serial killers. Sure, we got a little problem with necrophilia. I admit it, but you came to us first, right?
Madonna has acknowledged that she uses homosexual activity on stage before her fans to desensitize them. She knows that if she shows homosexual activity over and over and over again, the convictions of her audiences will be eroded. Listen to what Madonna said to a homosexual magazine.
Can you go back and show the shot of the woman in the thigh highs with blood all over her? You tell me that is empowering for women. I'm sorry, I just don't accept it. You know what this does? This promotes violence in the sickest sense. You are taking beautiful, hot women in a society that loves violence, that in many times condones violence against women, and shows them like this. This is not good.